Most of us know gymnast Simone Biles as a goat, but this star calls her friend Maggie Nichols the Michael Jordan of college gymnastics. When Maggie was left out of the Olympics, many fans felt it was a major mistake. But despite the setback, this gymnast has a ton to be proud of.
It was such an honor competing out in the world stage and doing the all-around and helping Team USA win gold.
Top-tier athletes like Maggie Nichols almost always get an early start, and gymnastics has been an important part of her life since she was only 3 years old. Apparently, a young Maggie just couldn't stop climbing all over the furniture, and her parents hoped signing her up for gymnastics lessons would help her get out some of that energy and save their living room from destruction. Maggie claims it was love at first somersault, and she was serious about the sport from an early age.
She's, you know, cutting the line to get more turns because I just loved it.
By the time she was 9 years old, she was already dreaming of becoming a part of the Olympic gymnastics team. And Maggie wasn't the only one who believed in her dream. Oklahoma coach KJ Kindler said there are several different things that go into making a champion. In addition to talent, a gymnast needs resources, access, and a supportive family. And Maggie had all of those. She competed in her first national event at the age of 11 and finished first on the uneven bars at the 2009 Women's U.S. Junior Olympic National Championships. Not only were her coaches impressed, but so were her fellow gymnasts, including her friend and teammate Simone Biles. These two have always been supportive of one another, with Simone calling Maggie the Michael Jordan of college gymnastics. They were teammates at the 2015 World Championships, with Simone winning the all-around title and Maggie competing in all four events. In addition to respecting Maggie as a fellow gymnast, Simone also says Maggie is the sweetest person she's ever met in her life. Some fans refer to Maggie as the Simone Biles of college gymnastics, but Simone insists Maggie is simply herself, and that's amazing. And as you might imagine, Maggie has definitely put in the effort to reach her level of skill. By the time she was 13 years old, she was training 4.5 hours every day after school, and the beam was her favorite event. Needless to say, time management was an essential skill for Maggie to master, and she often resorted to completing her schoolwork on rides to and from gymnastics meets. For a while, it seemed as though Maggie competing in the Olympics was a sure thing. She was one of the greatest NCAA gymnasts of all time and was ranked number one in the nation in all-around and vault. But after placing third in the all-around competition at the 2014 Pan American Gymnastics Championships, she dislocated her kneecap and was forced to withdraw from selection camp. And unfortunately, this wouldn't be her only career-altering injury. In 2016, Maggie tore her meniscus during training, which meant serious knee surgery and 2 months without competing. This also meant she didn't make the 2016 Summer Olympics team after being a serious contender for some time. It was devastating for Maggie, who felt she had so much more to accomplish. She announced her retirement from elite gymnastics, but she wasn't done with the sport yet. After taking some time off to recover, Maggie kicked off her NCAA career at the University of Oklahoma and went on to complete a gym slam.
It's so amazing to be back home. I'm so excited to compete in front of like my family and my friends, old teammates.
This means she achieved a perfect 10 on each apparatus, a feat only 11 NCAA female gymnasts have ever accomplished. While some fans were surprised Maggie gave up on her Olympic dreams, many of her fellow athletes think that she made the right call. Gymnast Kyla Ross has won Olympic gold and said that unless they're number one, elite athletes rarely get the respect they deserve. Like Maggie, Kyla also retired to focus on her college career and says competing at a collegiate level is every bit as fulfilling and gives athletes even more recognition. Maggie admits she was sad when she first learned she didn't make the team, but her sadness quickly turned to excitement when she thought about the opportunities she would have in Oklahoma. Maggie's career is not short on achievements or accolades, and all the more impressive is how she kept going after her dream of the Olympics was cut short. Unfortunately, due to the COVID-19 pandemic, the 2020 NCAA championships were cut short, so Maggie has had to adjust her dreams yet again. But don't worry, because this intrepid athlete is still dreaming big. Her major is health and exercise science, and it's clear athletics will always be a part of her life in one way or another. Looking back at her career, Maggie says she's happy with how it turned out and that she doesn't think it could have ended any better. When she was younger, she set goals for herself regarding her college college career, she wanted to score a perfect 10 just once, and ended up scoring 22 of them. Maggie didn't just achieve her goals, she vaulted right over them. Maggie doesn't want to be remembered as a gymnast. Instead, she hopes that her story inspires other people and that fans appreciate her kindness and character as much as her incredible skills. She's interested in pursuing a career as a sports broadcaster and might even write a book about her experiences someday. It's easy to look at her stats and see that Maggie is an amazing athlete, but the reality is that she's so much more. What do you think about Maggie Nichols not making the Olympic team? Do you think she should have made it, or is she better off participating in smaller events? Let us know what you think in the comment section below, and don't forget to click subscribe for more videos from us here at The Taco. Bye for now!